Upwork sent an email to all non-US freelancers and we all freaked out. But there is nothing to worry about. Let me just show you why and what you need to do. Why does Upwork all of a sudden need this information? This is not something new. Whenever you filled your profile information, you've already mentioned your name and your tax address where you are taxed. These forms and updates are required for the International Revenue Service to make sure that all US citizens pay their taxes. If you are a non-US person, this means that you need to take care of your own taxes in your own country. Upwork can only tax US citizens. However, if you fail to fill in this information as a non-US citizen, Upwork will start charging 30% from your account and will send this information to IRS, International Revenue Service. If you fill out the form correctly, you won't be charged any additional percentage from Upwork to prove that you are a non-US citizen. Let's see how we can do this. Oh yeah, and you have only 1 month left to fill in this information. It's needed by the end of December, December 31st. Go to Upwork.com, click on your profile picture, then settings. In the settings section, click tax information. This is where we need to do all of the work. Here you will see two sections, tax information and W-8. Now, tax residence, what we do here? Click on the plus icon to see all the changes you need to make. Here we have three options, use the profile address and use the billing address. Also, you can add all this information manually. I recommend adding the address where you are actually registered, not where you live, because usually all the tax related information is done through the address that where you are registered. Maybe you live in a different city in the same country, but your taxes will be directed to the address where you are registered. Let's go to the second section. The first one is I'm not a US person and I am a US person. Because you are not a US person, click not a US person. This should be already done for you. The next step is your legal name and surname. This is already, again, filled in for you. The name and surname that is identified in your ID, passport, whatever you have. And then federal tax classification. Here we have several options: individual, corporation, partnership, and other entity type. If you are an individual, just click individual. Most of you are individual freelancers, so you just have to choose the individual version. And then date of birth, your date of birth as it is identified in your ID, passport, and country of citizenship. After you click save, you will see another section, tax identification number. This is the number that is identified for you as a taxpayer. In most countries, this might be different, but generally, this is the ID number that you have. I recommend checking out this information with your local tax payers information. In my case, the tax ID number is the same as my social card number. So I'm just going to fill in my social card number. After that, click save, and this is all of the information that you need to provide as a tax identification number and as a proof that you are not a US person, you are not a US taxpayer.